Good day. I'm Norman Wildberger, and we're establishing proper foundations for geometry. Today's lecture is a very important one because we make the transition from 20th century geometry to 21st century geometry. We do that by introducing a better form of measurement than that is classically used, one that actually goes back to the ancient Greeks. We also establish the two most important theorems in all of mathematics. So I remind you that up till now we've been talking about points and lines. A point for us is an ordered pair of rational numbers. We are working only over the rational number field. A line is a proportion of three rational numbers. And we say that the point A lies on the line L precisely when A times X plus B times Y plus C equals zero. Now we want to establish an idea of separation between points. We have two points. How are we going to measure how far those points are apart? The traditional answer is distance. But as we've seen, Euclid does not use distance, and we're not going to either. We're going to use something more akin to what the ancient Greeks did, the notion of quadrance. The quadrance between two points, A1 and A2, is given by this simple formula. The difference between the x-coordinate squared plus the difference in the y-coordinate squared. That ensures that that's always a rational number. There's no square roots that we're taking, so we stay inside the domain in which we work. Some obvious properties. First of all, it's symmetric. If you interchange the A1 and the A2, the quadrance does not change. Secondly, the quadrance is zero precisely when the two points are actually the same. Because if this squared plus this squared equals zero, then this must be zero and this must be zero as well. And finally, the quadrance is always a positive number because the squares are always positive. So in our mind, a point is really an object in the coordinate plane. For example, the point 2, 1 really represents, in our mind, this point here with x-coordinate 2 and y-coordinate 1. And the point B with coordinate 6, 2 represents this point here. What's the quadrance between A and B? Well, by definition, it's the difference between the x-coordinates squared plus the difference between the y-coordinates squared for a total of 17. And what is the meaning of that geometrically? It has a very simple meaning, the quadrance does. It is just the area of the square built on that segment. That's exactly the kind of quantity that the ancient Greeks used in their understanding of geometry. And moreover, this quantity can be calculated without any irrational numbers, because we can subdivide this square into pieces whose areas we can count. C, D, and E are three collinear points. The three quadrances formed by them, you can calculate easily, are 10, 40, and 90. So that quadrance is 10, that quadrance is 40, and that quadrance is 90. And an absolutely fundamental question is, what is the relationship between these three numbers? Okay, the other important problem is when we have a right triangle like this, where this line and this line are perpendicular. You can calculate that the quadrances here are 5, 20, and 25. I think you probably all know what the relationship between these three numbers is. But the relationship between these three numbers is almost as important. Historically, Pythagoras' theorem comes first, so let's look at that one first. We have three points, A1, A2, and A3. And in general, we'll use the notation that Q1 represents the quadrance between A2 and A3, Q2 represents the quadrance between A1 and A3, and Q3 represents the quadrance between A1 and A2. Then Pythagoras' theorem states that A1, A3, which is the line through these two points, is perpendicular to A2, A3, the line between these two points, precisely when this relation between the quadrances holds. Q3 equals Q1 plus Q2. And this is the way Euclid stated the theorem as well. He did not state it in terms of distances squared. He stated in terms of areas of squares, which is exactly what these quadrances represent. So this is a more modern, but also more ancient form of this most important theorem. Now let's have a look at a proof. So we'll suppose that A1, A2, and A3 have coordinates x1, y1, x2, y2, x3, y3. Now, we've already established a theorem that tells us what the line is joining two points. So here's the line between A1 and A3. And here's the line joining A2 and A3 in terms of the coordinates. We also know, by definition, what it means for these two lines to be perpendicular. They're perpendicular precisely when this times this plus this times this equals zero. Now let's have a look at the right-hand side. Up here, we have Q3 equals Q1 plus Q2. So let's look at Q1 plus Q2 minus Q3. There's Q1, there's Q2, and there we've subtracted Q3. And when you work that out, you expand it all out, you have a good look at what it is, and then you can verify that what you end up getting is 2 times this expression. And what is this expression? It's exactly the expression that occurred up here. So, when this expression is 0, then this expression is 0, meaning that Q1 plus Q2 equals Q3. And conversely, when this expression is 0, then this expression is 0, meaning that the two lines are perpendicular. This is a completely algebraic proof of Pythagoras' theorem. It doesn't involve any pictures. It is therefore more powerful than any proof involving pictures. It extends, in other words, to many other situations and other fields as well. Now let's have a look at the other crucial and important result. Okay, so here is the second most important theorem in mathematics. It's called the triple quad formula. And using exactly the same notation as we've had, the line A1, A3 is parallel to the line A2, A3, precisely when this relation holds. Q3 minus Q1 minus Q2 all squared equals 4 times Q1 times Q2. That's more complicated than Pythagoras' theorem, and it's perhaps no surprise that Euclid did not discover this theorem. Here's a proof. Or at least an outline of a proof. These two lines are parallel precisely when the three points are collinear. In our previous video, we've established when three points are collinear. It comes down to this expression being zero in the coordinates of the points. Now let's look at the difference between the left and the right-hand side. There's the right-hand side minus the left-hand side. That's an expression involving lots of Q1s, Q2s, Y1s, and Y2s, and so on. When you substitute that in, expand it all out, then a remarkable factorization appears. You end up getting 4 times this quantity squared. And this quantity that's appearing here is exactly the same as this quantity. So this being 0 implies that this equals 0, and this being 0 implies that this equals 0. In other words, the three points are collinear precisely when this algebraic relation holds. This is a very important result. And with the Pythagoras' theorem, these are the two main pillars of metrical geometry in the plane. And this is all described at some length in my YouTube series called Wild Trig on Rational Trigonometry, which I strongly suggest that you have a look at. Next time, we're going to look at the separation between two lines and introduce the important idea of a spread. I hope you'll join me for that. I'm Norman Wildberger. Thanks for listening.